Good morning. I called you guys out this morning and called this press conference because I want to draw attention to let the voters of St. Petersburg know they can vote starting today, like I just did. We have, I'm sorry, they're waving at you. I have, it's, for me, this is a culmination. It's been a long, hard battle. As you know, over 2 years ago, I made a motion to have the people, my colleagues, let the people of St. Petersburg vote on the fate of the pier and your waterfront. And after two long petition drives, over 40,000 petitions being signed, over 23,000 people signing both, you finally get your say. You finally get to vote. You finally get to take some of the power back from the people you entrusted the power to have a say on what happens on your waterfront. And today is the first day you can do just that, and that's just what I've just done. So I encourage you to vote, to come out and vote. You can vote early. Can't vote often. This is not Chicago. But it's a joy for me to be able to vote. That's all I ever wanted, was the people have the right to vote on the fate of the waterfront. I get a vote, you get a vote. We are stewards of the taxpayers' resources and money. We don't own it. It belongs to you, the voters. So I thought it robbery not to let you have a vote on it. You get a vote, I get a vote. And today you can exercise your right to do just that. I just voted, and I don't mind telling you, will I get in trouble, Madam Clerk, if I tell them why I voted? I won't. I don't mind telling you that I voted yes on the referendum. And also I voted for Kathleen Ford for mayor. That's who I'm endorsing for mayor. I think a woman would do great, woman leadership. Pam Arroyo did an excellent job in Tampa. They have a woman police chief who's doing a yeoman's job over there. I have no problem with the kind of governments and governance that she'll bring to this city. We have a multitude of problems. I know she can lead this ship. I know she can bring these people together. And she has my most utmost confidence and support in this mayoral election. I would like to ask the people to join with me to support Ms. Ford. She was the only one who fought for you when your elected officials turned away the opportunity for you to vote the first time. She took it amongst her own self with her own money on her own time. She's not a public servant. She's not receiving any public funds to sue the city just to make sure your right to have a vote and a say on the pier comes to fruition. So she's a champion in my eyes. And she didn't have to do it, but she did. So I think I owe her a debt of gratitude, and I wish her the best in this election, and I'm going to do all I can to make sure she prevails.
Expect high voter turnout since two issues?
The primary election, yes, I do. There's a lot of things that are going on. As you read the stories in the paper, we had another one released just this weekend about the enormous amount of gas that's being used on vehicles that leave the city. You know, we got a lot of people that don't live in this city taking your taxpayer equipment and money to go home. It's just to drive back and forth home, and you got to foot the bill. No one's paying $3.50 a gallon or $3.40 a gallon for gas for you. No one's paying your maintenance payments or your car payments for you to get back and forth to work. So why should you support something else? And even before that, I think last year, it was another problem with the car allowance, if you remember. I brought that up. It's just every time you bring these items up, it just appalls me to how the people you elected into office to be good stewards of your assets and money just turn a blind eye to it and make it like it's okay. It's not okay. It's your money. We say we swore to be good stewards of your assets and your money. We can't turn a blind eye, especially when it's been brought to our attention. So I'm hopeful that a lot of this will be brought to light. You know, we're putting out what I call self-imposed deficits to be able to tax you more when we should be better resources on the taxes you already entrusted to us. But whenever you question something like that, you become an outsider. But I'll be that outsider. Someone has to speak for the people. That's what I've always done. That's what I will continue to do.
Newt, you said you voted yes on the referendum. What does that mean? Could you explain to people what voting yes on the referendum means?
On the referendum, the question is an ordinance terminating the Michael Molson new pier design agreement based on the Lance concept. This is terminating the contract on the Lance.
Hang on.
This terminates the contract on the Lance. As you know, the last time the city attempted something this mammoth was Tropicana Field. They spent 30-40% of your tax money. You never got a vote. That was forced down your throat. The Lance has the same makings of that. This belongs to you, the people. you should have a vote, you should have a say. And I don't think it's right for us to take the approach to spend $3.9 million of your money that we're never going to get back on a project without you having a vote first and foremost. In 2010, when I requested to let the people vote, we had spent at that point $167,000. And that would have been the right time to do it. You'll hear arguments now about we spent too much to go back, or we can't do this and we can't do that. It's your money. These are people you elected. These are people also getting paid by your tax dollar. It's supposed to represent you. It's government by the people, for the people.
Can you talk a little bit about the Voting Rights Act and if you think there's hope that Congress can come up with a plan that's going to allow more Americans to be able to vote?
Well, Congress is, it wasn't the Congress, it was the Supreme Court on the Voting Rights Act. It took away some of the reassurance that people had to make sure that they vote, get counted, and they have access to vote. And they're putting it in the hands of the people who were creating those situations, which I think is asinine. That's like letting the wolf guard the sheep. I mean, that ain't gonna look too good. But we will be vigilant. Ms. Ford has worked at different precincts doing the presidential elections and the previous elections, making sure people had access to vote. That's what she done, on her own dime, on her own time. And that's the kind of things people need to be doing when they look to seek leadership. You can't pop up and do something when it's convenient for you just to be able to get elected. I don't think that's a good model.
Councilman, the people that say we've spent $3.9 million, what are we gonna do to replace that money? I mean,
you won't get that money back. If you notice, I voted no all along. I voted no until the people get a chance to vote. I wasn't going to vote for it until the people can vote for it. And now the people didn't like it. Numerous polls told me they didn't like it. And I'm going by just what they're saying. They don't like it. It's not going to happen in my eyes. But everybody gets to vote. That's the beauty of a democracy. The Supreme Court has said the right to vote is the most protected among all other rights. Of course, the very foundation our democracy is built on. And answer your question about the money's been spent, i.e. we ain't getting it back. I asked, if you follow the council hearings, I would always ask legal, how much of this money is we gonna get back? And the answer was none. So the money's gone.
Well, some of the money is actually for regardless of what goes out there, whether it's a refurbishment or
they'll tell you that they're gonna do this and they're gonna do that, but the problem is this, you can't put the wagon before the horse. If you're gonna spend that enormous amount of money, you need to let the people have a say. If you're gonna get rid of a historic icon asset that belongs to the people need to have a say. Now, if the people vote to go forward with this and tear down the pier, I'll drive the bulldozer. I will, but let the people vote.
You get a shot of that one there?
Yes.